Good day to all of you. Myself, Dr. Arvind Sharma, Associate Professor in Physics, Government Dungur College, Bikaner. Today we are going to discuss the same topic, one-dimensional linear harmonic oscillator using Schrodinger equation according to your book. In previous lecture, I explained this topic according to a paper that is very good written. And today we are discussing this topic according to your book. So we go through this article quickly. The wave equation for oscillator. We know that particle undergoing simple harmonic motion in one dimensional simple harmonic oscillator is known as simple harmonic oscillator. And in simple harmonic motion, the restoring force is proportional to force. F equal to minus kx. F according to Newton's law, F equal to md2 x upon dt2. Equation of motion you can easily calculate, and frequency omega equal to under root k by m. Here the main thing that we need, potential energy. Potential energy is half kx squared. And in one dimensional Schrodinger equation, if we replace the potential energy V here, half kx squared. Okay, and after that, using these two constants, alpha square equal to under root mk upon h bar square, and lambda equal to twice c under root m upon h bar k square. So using these equations, we just try to rearrange the equation. This is the method to rearrange the equation, and it can be easily understandable by you, breaking this term and some thing is doing here, and taking this term outside, and using this kind of things, we just convert this equation by using these conventional constants, conventional variables alpha square and lambda, in terms of alpha 1 upon alpha square del 2 psi upon del x2 plus lambda minus alpha square x square psi equal to 0. For convenience, let us relate q with x. Some new variable q that is related to x with q equal to alpha x, and we just replace q and delta psi upon delta x, delta 2 psi upon delta x2 according to this variable, and our equation converted into delta 2 psi upon delta q2 plus lambda minus q square psi equal to 0. So this is very simple. This is the point to be understandable, asymptotic solutions. To solve equation 12, well, let us first make the attempt to obtain an asymptotic solution. For the case when q square greater than 1, if q square greater than lambda, then this term is negligible. So this equation becomes here only q square term, and the solution is psi equal to e raised to plus minus q square upon 2. Okay, it can be easily seen from here that if it is substituted in this equation, and if we take q square plus minus equal to q square 1, then this becomes, equation becomes like that, double derivative equal to q square psi. Okay. Thus, clearly, out of these two solutions represented only term, only term that is important for, that is physically acceptable, is only term is that e square q square upon 2 and e square e raised to minus q square upon 2, only physically acceptable. E psi equal to q square upon 2 is not acceptable since it is increasing with increasing x. While the solution psi equal to e square e raised to minus q square upon 2 satisfy the condition. Here is minus sign is. There is a mistake here. This is the psi equal to e raised to minus q square upon 2 satisfy the condition, therefore is an asymptotic solution of the wave function. Recursion relation. From above consideration, it is clear that solution of equation 12 will contain only term e raised to minus q square upon 2 as a factor. For possible solution, may be written as psi equal to e raised to minus q square upon 2 phi cube. That means this is only this, not only that this is the term, but some function of q is also with this, and we try to simplify or solve this equation. You just put this equation, you just put this solution in the above equation, and the terms can be easily done by you. Okay, you can easily do these parts. We also understand. Again, phi q. What is phi q? Phi q is again power series of q, as we do in previous lecture. Phi q equal to q raised to s, summation r equal to 0 to infinity ar q raised to r equal to summation r ar q raised to s plus r. Again, double derivative, single double, and we are just replacing these equations in the above part. So equation becomes like that. If we put these equations, these terms in this equation, then this is the equation 23 we got. Now, this equation is a power series and is satisfied only if coefficient of each power in Q must be separately equal to 0, equating to the 0 coefficient of lowest power of Q, we get a0s minus 1 equal to 0. Because a0 not equal to 0, being first of power series, we have s equal to 0 or s equal to 1. Now equating to 0 the coefficient of q raised to s minus 1, we get a1 s plus 1 s equal to 0. This gives either a1 equal to 0 or s equal to 0 or s equal to minus 1. As s not equal to minus 1, we have either a1 equal to 0, s equal to 0 or both. Now equating the coefficient for q raised to s plus r, then you can easily go to the recursion relation for ar plus 2 as we get in previous lecture. Here r is integer or 0. This expression called recursion formula. From this we can calculate the coefficients of even power of q. Q0 is known. Similarly, we can calculate q raised to odd powers if coefficient q1 is known. Thus, we choose a1 equal to 0. Then all odd coefficients, ar will be 0. All odd coefficients of ar will be 0. Examining this series, if we examine this series, then this is like as limit n tending to infinity n plus 2 upon n. This result is 2 upon n. If we compare this result with the series e raised to k square up e raised to q square, we know 1 plus q square plus q4 upon factorial 2, so on, equal to 1 plus v2 q square plus v4 q4 plus so on. The recursion formula for the exponential series e raised to q square is given by, if we see this recursion relation, that bn plus 2. This is bn plus 2 upon bn equal to factorial n upon 2 upon factorial n by 2 plus 1 equal to 1 upon 1 upon 2 n plus 1. N is very large, so that unity is negligible in comparison with the n by 2. The above equation gives similar result as we got. Thus, we see that for large values of n, the series phi q will behave like e raised to q square. That means our solution psi equal to e raised to minus q square upon 2 phi q. Now phi q behaves as a e raised to q square. So solution becomes e raised to q square upon 2. Okay. According to this equation, q tending to infinity, psi tending to infinity, thus making the wave function physically unacceptable. Thus, the series governed by the recursion formula does not lead to a satisfactory wave function. unless some restriction is introduced which makes the series break off after a finite terms. Point to be noted that the result which we get from the recursal relation does not lead to satisfactory wave function. So, to get the satisfactory wave function, some restriction is introduced which makes the series break off after a finite number of terms. Okay, eigenvalues of harmonic oscillator. From above discussion, we have seen that in order to obtain a satisfactory wave function, the series must break off after a finite terms. The series will break off after rth term if we get the numerator is 0. In the recursion relation, if numerator is 0, then this recursion formula according, the series will break off. And numerator is given by this term and it becomes 0. Then lambda equal to twice s plus 2r plus 1. For s equal to 0, lambda equal to twice r plus 1. And for s equal to 1, lambda equal to twice r plus 3. Thus, equation 31 may be written more generally, lambda equal to 2n plus 1 for n equal to 0, 1, 2, 3. And we know that lambda equal to twice e under root m upon h bar square k. So, this is equal to 2n plus 1. And by using this relation and k equal to m omega square, we can easily obtain the eigenvalues of harmonic oscillator En equal to n plus half h cross omega. Okay. Significance of zero energy. What is here? Zero energy if n equal to zero, E equal to half h cross omega, that is known as zero point energy, ground state energy. And the energy we can easily see from here, from this figure, E versus X. So this becomes here only discrete energies are possible. Half h cross omega 3 by 2, 5 by 2, 7 by 2, so on. For ground state energy n equal to 0, this is called zero point energy. A comparison with the result E equal to n h cross omega 0 obtained by old quantum theory shows that only difference is that all the equally spaced energy levels are shifted upwards. By an amount equal to half the separation of energy levels, half h cross omega 0 equals to 0 point energy. Even in the lowest state, the harmonic oscillator has finite energy while according to classical mechanics. Harmonic oscillator possesses zero energy at lowest state. Zero energy at lowest state. The existence of zero point energy is an agreement with experiment and is important feature of quantum mechanics. Now, eigenfunctions. We have seen that in order to have a satisfactory solution of wave equation, phi must break off after a finite number of terms. That is, phi should be restricted in such a manner so as to make it a polynomial rather than a power series. We are taking it power series, but rather than it is a polynomial. The best suitable polynomial is Hermite polynomial denoted by h and q, and eigenfunction can be set equal to the product of polynomial h and q and factor e raised to minus q square upon 2. So psi n x equal to nn e raised to minus q square upon 2 h and q, where h and q is Hermite polynomial of nth degree and its expression is given by this. H and q equal to minus 1 raised to n e raised to q square dn e raised to minus q square upon dq. And some values of different orders of Hermite polynomial is also given. Hermite polynomial obeys the orthogonality condition we already seen in last lecture. And for normalization conditions, if we put the wave function in this normalization condition, then we can easily obtain the value of normalization constant using the property of the Hermite polynomials and using this equation. This standard equation result, if we use, then we can easily get the result of nn normalization constant equal to under root alpha upon 2 raised to n factorial capital N under root pi. And by using this relation, normalized wave function of harmonic oscillator R psi nx equal to alpha upon 2 raised to n factorial n under root pi raised to half e raised to minus alpha I square x square upon 2 hn alpha x. Okay. So, the wave function we derive here, if we want to calculate the lowest state of energy, it becomes psi x equal to under root alpha upon under root pi e raised to minus alpha I square upon x square. And these are the plots we already discussed in last lecture. Psi q versus q, first order, second order, and third order. So you can easily plot these functions. Okay. These are the functions for, and if we plot the probability functions, then all are positive and magnitude is also increases. So you can easily understand here, probability function, lowest energy, eigenvalue energies. We know that probability distribution function does not vary smooth but show n plus 1 maxima for energy states. Okay. The wave mechanical predictions of the harmonic oscillator have been verified experimentally, thus establishing the superiority of wave function of wave mechanics over classical mechanics. Superiority of wave mechanics over classical mechanics, such kind of result is only due to quantum mechanical concepts. After that, parity and something more is explained here. So you go through it, you can easily understand. Uncertainty relation can also be derived from here, and you can do this easily. There are many questions also explained with this. Zero point energy of oscillator using uncertainty relation, that is already you understand in your UG class. Zero point energy again given here. So do these numericals and next things you can easily done. Okay. So we do the article of solution of harmonic oscillator using Schrodinger equation by the explanation and mathematics of your book, and in the previous lecture with the well-known or very interesting lecture. So this is the very important question. So I explain in two lectures. So you also do the mathematical steps very clearly. You just understand and you do the all steps very carefully, because this equation, this question is very important for you in the examination point of view. In next lectures, we continue this unit. Thanks to all of you.